name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. Well, good morning to you all, and a very warm welcome to this, our service for the baptism of our Lord. The grace of God has dawned upon the world through our Saviour, Jesus Christ, who sacrificed himself for us to purify a people as his own. So let us confess our sins. Wash away all my iniquity and cleanse me from my sin. Lord, have mercy. Against you only have I sinned and done what is evil in your sight. Christ, have mercy. Create in me a pure heart, O God, and renew a steadfast spirit within me. Lord, have mercy. May the God of all healing and forgiveness draw you to himself, that you may behold the glory of his Son, the Word made flesh, and be cleansed from all your sins, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us pray. Eternal Father, who at the baptism of Jesus revealed him to be your Son, anointing him with the Holy Spirit, grant to us who are born again by water and the Spirit that we may be faithful to our calling as your adopted children. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Please be seated. Alleluia. Christ was revealed in flesh, proclaimed among the nations, and believed in throughout the world. Alleluia. Hear the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Luke. In the wilderness, John proclaimed a baptism of repentance. As the people were filled with expectation, and all were questioning in their hearts concerning John, whether he might be the Messiah, John answered all of them, saying, "I baptize you with water, but one who is more powerful than I is coming. I am not worthy to untie the thong of his sandals. He will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and fire. His winnowing fork is in his hand to clear his threshing floor and to gather the wheat into his granary. But the chaff he will burn with unquenchable fire." Now when all the people were baptized, and when Jesus also had been baptized and was praying, the heaven was opened, and the Holy Spirit descended upon him in a bodily form like a dove. And a voice came from heaven, "You are my Son, the Beloved. With you I am well pleased." This is the Gospel of the Lord. May I speak in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. This morning we hear Luke's account of the baptism of Christ. From the very beginning of his gospel, Luke shows the close link between Jesus and John. Both were announced by an angel. Both were conceived in difficult circumstances. Elizabeth was barren in her old age. Mary was an unmarried lady, a very young lady at that. And both were part of God's divine plan. John was to be the forerunner, the herald of Jesus, who is the Messiah. And Luke shows that all this took place because God wants to be with us. One of the titles for Christ is, of course, Emmanuel, meaning God with us. God's longing for solidarity with his people is so strong, his desire for unity so great, that he becomes one of us and lived on earth among us. Having reflected upon the importance of John in our Lord's incarnation during Advent, we can picture the scene of Jesus' baptism. There's a real buzz around John. The people sense that God is doing something amazing. Filled with anticipation, they wonder if John is the long-awaited Messiah. And John responds with humility. "I'm not even worthy to untie the thongs of his sandals," he tells them. And then he tells them that he will baptize them with water, but the Messiah will baptize them with the Holy Spirit and with fire. So like a signpost, John points beyond himself as he witnesses to Jesus. But why was it necessary for Jesus to be baptized if he is the Savior, the Messiah of the Lord, the Anointed One, as Luke refers to him in his birth narrative? Well, the importance of Jesus' baptism is twofold. Firstly, it marked the beginning of Jesus' public ministry, which led him to the cross. But Christ's baptism also demonstrates the solidarity of the Holy Trinity with humanity. The whole point of the incarnation, which we recall during this season of Christmastide, and the whole point of the passion, death, and resurrection, which we recall during Holy Week and Easter, is God's solidarity with his people. And this solidarity is once again demonstrated in Christ's baptism. Christ didn't need to be baptized, but he accepted his baptism as a sign of unity and solidarity with humanity. Luke then tells his audience that when Jesus and all the people had been baptized, as he was praying, the heavens were opened and the Holy Spirit descended upon Jesus, and God's voice was heard, "You are my Son, the Beloved. With you I am well pleased." So immediately we hear of the presence of the Holy Trinity, the Father's voice, the Son's baptism, the Spirit descending. Generation after generation of Christians have been baptized in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The Holy Trinity present and active in creation and in Christ's public ministry is present and active in our own lives and our ministries. Emmanuel, God with us. But baptism, of course, is only the first stage of our initiation. Today in our reading from Acts, an early example of confirmation is heard, and it links the initiation rites of the church. We hear Peter teaching that those who have received the word of God also need to receive his Spirit. In baptism, our unity with the Holy Spirit is publicly made, and we receive Jesus into our lives. In confirmation, we declare our solidarity with God, as by the laying on of hands, the bishop and all present pray for us to receive the Holy Spirit into our lives. And we maintain our solidarity with God, who is with us, through our attentiveness to the Holy Spirit. After his baptism, Jesus prayed. Throughout the Gospels, Jesus teaches about prayer and is seen to be busy at prayer. And whilst he was praying, the Holy Spirit descended upon him. Earlier in the passage, of course, John dismissed the claim that he was the Messiah, saying Jesus will come and baptize with the Holy Spirit. Now we hear how Jesus himself receives the Holy Spirit. By taking place in this way, a third reason for the baptism of Christ emerges. It's the fulfillment of the Old Testament prophecies, particularly Isaiah's. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he has anointed me to bring good news to the poor. He sent me to proclaim liberty to the captives and recovery of the sight to the blind, to let the oppressed go free, to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor. Jesus is anointed by the Holy Spirit in order to do God's work. And it's through our prayer that we discern the stirring of the Holy Spirit in our lives. Prayer is an expression of our solidarity with God, and it enables us to do the work he calls us to do. So prayer must always be our priority, but it must be followed by action. Jesus prayed and then he acted. And his actions are always powerful, as ours can be too. Finally, Luke announces the revelation of God on the scene, John announces the arrival of God on the scene, completing the revelation of the Trinity. A voice came from heaven saying, "You are my Son, the Beloved. With you I am well pleased." God publicly affirms the message of the angel to Mary and to the shepherds. Jesus is God's beloved Son, the one foretold by the prophets, the one anticipated by the Jews, the one the crowds flocked to find in John, the one John pointed them to. Today, as we reflect on Christ's baptism, it's good for us to call to mind our own baptism. For many of us, our solidarity with God was declared by our parents and our godparents as we were tiny infants. But we've made that choice for ourselves in adulthood through the sacrament of confirmation. Seeking solidarity with God in all things, let us continue to pray for the wisdom, guidance, and inspiration of the Holy Spirit to strengthen us and to equip us to do God's will, living as those who know ourselves to be his beloved children. Amen. So we now stand and affirm our faith in God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate from the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us pray. High and holy God, robed in majesty, Lord of heaven and earth, We pray that you will bring justice, faith and salvation to all peoples. Lord, hear us. You chose us in Christ to be your people and to be the temple of your Holy Spirit. We pray that you will fill your church with the vision of, with vision and hope. Lord, hear us. Your Spirit enables us to cry, Abba, Father. It affirms that we are fellow heirs with Christ and pleads for us in our weakness. We pray for all who are in need or distress. Lord, hear us. In the baptism and birth of Jesus, you have opened heaven to us and enabled us to share in your glory. The joy of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit from before the world was made. We pray for the souls of Rob Dickinson and on their year's mind, Joyce Mack and Stephen Dowell. May your whole church, living and departed, come to a joyful resurrection in the city of light. Lord, hear us. Holy God, let your abundant blessing descend from heaven upon your church to confirm and create anew those who in the sacrament of baptism have been washed in water and born again in the life-giving Spirit. We ask this through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Our Saviour Christ is the Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and of peace there shall be no end. The peace of the Lord be always with you. Open the heavens, Holy Spirit, for us to see Jesus interceding for us. May we be willing to share his baptism, ready to share his cup, and strengthened to serve him forever. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. All honour and praise be yours always and everywhere, mighty Creator, ever-living God, through Jesus Christ, your only Son, our Lord. For at this time we celebrate your glory made present in our midst. In the coming of the Magi, the King of all the world was revealed to the nations. In the waters of baptism, Jesus was revealed as the Christ, the Saviour sent to redeem us. In the water made wine, the new creation was revealed at the wedding feast. Poverty was turned into riches, sorrow into joy. Therefore, with all the angels of heaven, we lift our voices to proclaim the glory of your name and sing our joyful hymn of praise. Lord, you are holy indeed, the source of all holiness. Grant that by the power of your Holy Spirit, and according to your holy will, these gifts of bread and wine may be to us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, who in the same night that he was betrayed, took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me." Praise to you, Lord Jesus. Dying, you destroyed our death. Rising, you restored our life. Lord Jesus, come in glory. And so, Father, calling to mind his death on the cross, his perfect sacrifice made once for the sins of the whole world, rejoicing in his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, and looking for his coming in glory, we celebrate this memorial of our redemption. As we offer you this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, we bring before you this bread and this cup, and we thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. Send the Holy Spirit on your people, and gather into one in your kingdom all who share this one bread and one cup, so that we, in the company of the Blessed Virgin Mary, St. George, St. James, and all the saints, may praise and glorify you forever, through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom, and with whom, and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory be yours, Almighty Father, for ever and ever. Amen. Believing in the promises of God, let us pray with confidence as our Saviour has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. We break the bread of life, and that life is the light of the world. God, here among us, light in the midst of us, bring us to light and life. Christ is the true bread which has come down from heaven. Lord, give us this bread always. Lord of all time and eternity, you opened the heavens and revealed yourself as Father in the baptism of Jesus, your beloved Son. By the power of your Spirit, complete the heavenly work of our rebirth through the waters of the new creation. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Faithful God, in baptism you have adopted us as your children, made us members of the body of Christ, and chosen us as inheritors of your kingdom. We thank you that in this Eucharist you renew your promises within us. Empower us by your Spirit to witness and to serve, and send us out as disciples of your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated. I've got the book for this holiday thing now. I've been taking a week off in November. I'm having another fortnight off this month. So you can see the arrangements for the worship there. I'm here next Sunday. Normal round of services next Sunday, but after that, reduced services. But the details are on the back of the order of service. And if anybody wants anything putting in the orders of service for the next 3 weeks, if you can get it to me by Thursday, please, and I'll print them all off on Friday. Christ, the Son of God, perfect in you the image of his glory and gladden your hearts with the good news of his kingdom. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord in the name of Christ.